Hello everybody, and so I'm just doing a video blog today. My original intention was to start a new project because, well, last week we finished the Maggie, and so I brought that to, like, up to my parents over Thanksgiving, and it was a big hit. You know, my niece was playing it, my wife was playing it. I think even my dad was playing at one point. So. Lot of fun. I still haven't had a chance to try any of the other games on it yet, though. So today being Tuesday, was going to be a Project Tuesday, but I made a little bit of a mistake. I left my laptop at work, and so the way my setup works is, when I do my project work downstairs in the basement, I use my laptop to drive the camera and the microphone, and then I do all my editing and then my intros on my main desktop upstairs, which is why I can still make a video today. I just can't record a project because I don't have the equipment I needed to. I have a video camera. I could use just the video camera. But the sound on it is pretty nasty, and especially, you know, once you get used to the microphone that I use on my usual videos, using the microphone on the camera, just I'm really not happy with it. So I'm going to put off the project till Thursday, and so today's just going to be a video blog, but. Let me at least show you the project that we will be working on Thursday. So it's going to be, it's another evil mad scientist project called the Bulbdial. And so let me just put up the information page here. The Bulbdial is. It's a clock. It's an analog clock that uses LEDs, and the idea is that it has a little point in the middle, and then LEDs go around the edge, so that the point in the middle creates a shadow. So in a way, it's kind of like a sundial, except. You're using LEDs on the clock, and as the LEDs go around the face, they create the shadow on the face. Now, the one I have also has the chrono dot add-on, and the rear projection screen. If you want to do this project along with me, I'll put a link to it in the description below. But so if you want to do the link with me, you don't have to get the chrono dot. The chrono dot doesn't add a lot to the project itself. It kind of comes as its own self-contained little module that's just plug onto the board. And the rear projection face, well, the only real difference there is where you mount the face. So when I put the clock together, I'll actually put it together, you know, first I'll put it with the normal back face, and then I'll put the rear projection face on afterwards. And, you know, that said, if just the base project kit, you should get along fine with it. And I do want to point out again that I am not being paid by Evil Mad Scientist to show off their products. I'm doing this because, you know, I saw the project on the website. It looked like a really neat project, so I picked it up same time that I bought the Maggie. I'm not going to do an unboxing and a component counting the way I did with the Maggie, because there actually isn't a lot of. There isn't really a lot of interesting pieces that go with the Bulbdial. You know, like you have, so you have your layers. So this is, so the blue is like the main circuit board for the clock. Then here's the just the normal front face. Then you can kind of see in behind here, like the red, and then there's another green one just in behind. So those are the different layers of the clock. And then the LEDs go on each of the layers, and then the different colors represent, I think blue is seconds, and then I think green is minutes, and then red is hours, or it could be green minute, or it could be red is minutes and green hours. I can't remember. I'd have to take a look at the instructions to be sure. And then it's got a whole whack load of LEDs, obviously. Obviously, because you know you need something for the light to actually go around the clock. And then this is really all the components, like all the other components it really gives you. So in here is your quartz crystal for your clock pulse, which then gets superseded by the chrono dot, which is I believe it's an Evil Mad Scientist product. It's basically just a real-time clock generator that then sends it generates an external pulse, and it's supposed to be a lot more accurate than the crystal oscillator that comes with this by default. Then of course there's another 80 mega chip on here. I believe it's the same one that they put on the Migi, which is also the same one that they put in the Uno. And then, you know, lots of resistors, lots of capacitors. But, you know, we'll look at those as we put them on the clock. Or as we put it on the circuit board. And then, what else we got in here? Then, you know, just some mounting hardware to put everything together. So, in a way, this... Although this may look like a more complex project when you first look at it, I think this might actually be a little simpler than the AT Mega, because it doesn't really need to drive as much. All this is really doing is just driving a bunch of LEDs, and it just has to know like which LED on each of the three circles to light up in order to generate your shadow. Yeah, definitely, you know, join me on Thursday or even in future videos. Again, you know, it's YouTube, it's recorded, you can go back and play it afterwards if you do pick up the project. But this really does look like a lot of fun, and I'm really looking forward to doing this one. And if nothing else, I actually don't have a clock in my office in here, so I'm really looking forward to actually having a clock in here too, so that I know, well, other than the clock down in the bottom corner of my screen, but just so that I know when I'm starting to run a little over for my recordings, or when I'm spending too long editing or playing games or the various other things I do in here. So that more or less does it. I'm really sorry this is a shorter video, and probably a shorter video blog for that matter, because this, it really kind of caught me by surprise. I was halfway home and I realized that, you know, I'd forgot my laptop at work, and then shortly after, almost immediately after, I was like, oh yeah, I needed that. But it was too late for me to go back for it. So yeah, I will try again. I should have some project video for you on Thursday. Put your comments down below. One thing I am looking for comments on is about the projects themselves, because one thing I noticed with the AT Mega was we didn't get like I didn't get a lot of views on them, and so of course, it makes me wonder, is this what people really want to see? Do you want to see me working on a project? Is there value to having these videos to work along with? Or even as instructional videos, because I'm sure there's better videos from people who are better at this than I am, who certainly don't stutter as much as I do, that may be worth following along. But if people do find these entertaining or instructional or instructive or then I'll keep doing them. But I at the very least I do have four projects that I'm going to be working on camera. The other two I still need to order. But and then once I'm done those four projects, we'll see where it goes. If the viewers do appreciate the project videos, then I'll keep doing them. And if not, then I'll find something else to do. I'll maybe do more stuff with Raspberry Pi and Arduinos and some of the other boards coming out. I just thought that project videos might be something worth something people might enjoy. So again, leave your comments down below. Subscribe to the channel if you think that to get updates on the videos and on the projects, and read my con read my posts on Facebook when I remember to post. I know I've actually forgotten the last couple times to post my videos on Facebook, but anyways, so I guess that about does it for today's video blog. Thank you very much for joining me today, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.